Yes.
Thank you for that. So now I'm talking about modeling. I'm going to look at the requirements from the client of design, and you ask for it. I will at the same time look at the needs and the ideas from the other stakeholders. I think I made it clear these are different things, at least from my point of view, but it makes sense to combine them. And in your case, it certainly does. So, and now I'm going to tell you a little bit about tools. One of the groups asked me about certain tools that could be used or techniques. Well, there's a lot of things. So you could try to find out, can I describe some kind of a persona for the main actors? Can I describe the actors in terms of their needs, their knowledge of the system, their education in relation to the system? Because that might show you that there are problems, that the typical student doesn't know how to handle, or the typical agent from the municipality doesn't know how to communicate the relevant information or whatever, right? So this would help. And you could work on this as a team. You could sit around the table, the three or four of you, and work on it. But you could also work on that with your client or with a stakeholder. It would be good to have a stakeholder discuss with you what's a typical persona, what would they know, what would be their education, what would be their goals, what would be the tools they use, right? So consider to use this not just as three or four usability experts or UGI experts or whatever you would call yourself, but take the people into the group that are, well, let me say, they live in the domain you're looking at, right? And the same is for developing a storyboard for a business process. A storyboard is a short story about how the business runs. And this is something you could try to scribble on a sheet of paper together with your client or together with the stakeholder. Let me make a sketch of. And the same is for a role script. If you identify roles, try to describe the role and talk to the people that are supposed to be playing that role, or are supposed to be delegating that role, or are, and in some cases a mood board. You know what a mood board is? So a mood board is about how should my business look like. Now, at least in the case of the food and beverage broker, I could imagine that how the business looks like, or how the business looks like for the different caterers, could be very important. So try to find out what they would like it to do, even if they are going to use like tablets or smartphones. If it looks good, then it would help them. If it doesn't look good, then maybe it would go away. So and then there are other techniques like group sketching, sitting around the table and just sketch the ideas or draw a diagram. Here you have this nice diagram over there. I'm not sure who made it, but such a diagram could well be made as a group where a client could be part of it, right? And say, no, this is not true. There are more students, or there are more stakeholders in the municipality or whatever. So, and the same is for a role script. And there are even techniques like headlines or service image, which, by the way, are techniques. You can find them on the website. I'm not going to discuss in detail. You might discuss tomorrow if you want. I will be happy about that. Headlines are a way of, suppose the redesign is finished and we are happy. How would we put it in the local newspaper? Or how would we put it in the student newspaper? Or how would we advertise it on our website, right? So, and a service image is the same thing. How would this thing look like? How should people understand it, right? So you could, in a way, start with the end. Suppose that your redesign is successful, is accepted, and is usable. How should we advertise it? How should it be seen in the local newspaper, right? Okay. And all these techniques, they are on the website, the task analysis. Not the website for this course, but the general website on task analysis. You will find all these techniques and try to consider them early on. And try to consider them with the relevant stakeholders and the client or users. Okay. So you could have interviews, we know. Observations in context is not that easy, maybe because the context takes time and the processes take time, but you could ask people to tell the story, or you could tell the story and ask them to check and to correct. And the same is for role playing. If there's a complex thing, you could say, okay, let's try to do this. I've seen, for instance, a situation where these were Romanian students, and I thought in Romania the culture was very, let me say, old-fashioned, and they were redesigning a bank situation, and so in a way I suggested them to play back. So one was the person, the cashier, and the other was the client, and I suggested them to sit on two sides of the table, and the cashier had a laptop. And what happened was that they spontaneously moved the chairs and sat behind the screen together. So here was redesign going on by two stakeholders, right? So so role play could take 5 minutes to ask people to act out, and you find out they say, wait, we could do it differently. And complex panorama is some kind of describing the whole situation in which the system is supposed to feature. All these techniques, they are on the website. If it makes sense, consider them. So looking at it takes you 3 minutes, and if it makes sense, you could try it out, well, maybe in collaboration with a stakeholder. So just an example of what my students did in Italy. So they made personas, and they described different types of personas for a local hotel, right? And it's 5 or 6 words, and they developed it in collaboration with somebody in the management of the hotel to find out what type of clients do we have. And a storyboard for the business process. You can see it's a very quick sketch, and this is how the receptionist explains to the design team how she works. And the design team is sketching, and she is giving the words, and you develop a storyboard, and you agree, okay, this is how we work, or this is how we would like to work. Okay, so a role script about the tourist. You can read it on the website, but this is Hotel Catalunya. This is one of the hotels that I frequent when I'm teaching. And this is how they describe about what tourists mention. And this is about buying a ticket and a ticket machine. This ticket machine doesn't exist. At least it didn't exist when the students made it. It was made up, just a sketch, right? Stolen stuff. And they said, okay, and this will be, I put, if the system would work, I should be able to choose my language. And then I should be able to choose my ticket and how many tickets I need. And I should be able to insert money and wait for the ticket and get it. And I should get my money back, right? So this is just a script made up by students without any physical or hardware solutions, and even not the software. So it's just a PowerPoint sketches that you could already discuss with the stakeholders.